Hello, and thank you for listening to this video tutorial of Decision Group's FIT, or Forensics Investigation Toolkit software. This is a powerful tool that can be downloaded on a Windows operating system, used to parse and reconstruct captured network traffic. Once you have downloaded the FIT software, it's time to install it. When you unpack it, find the setup application, and you'll be sent to the setup wizard, and you'll go through a series of steps for the installation process. When the installation process is complete, click the Finish button to end the process. Once you have finished installing the Forensics Investigation Toolkit software, go to the Start button to open it. If you're running the trial version, you'll see a prompt reminding you that this is a limited version. Click OK to continue. Now you'll see the user interface of the FIT software. Next, we'll look at the user interface. At the top of the window is the menu bar. Below the menu bar is the favorite functions bar. Below the favorite functions bar and to the left is the object list. And to the right of the objects list will be the record table. Finally, at the bottom is the data content list. As we continue through the guide, you will see each of these items in more detail. Now, let's parse and analyze our PCAP files. First, we need to create a new case. This can be done from the main menu bar, under File, or in the Favorite Features bar. Name your new case. Here, we will use case 1, and then add a description. Click OK when you're finished. Now, let's import our PCAP files. Click the Import Parse Case wizard, and then select the correct case. Click Next when you've selected the case. Now we see the Import Parse Case wizard. We can add our PCAP files. I will select 3 files for this example. Click Open when you've selected your files. For this example, I will also uncheck the Run Full Text Searching Index After Import option. If we leave this checked, we can search the reconstructed data by keyword. However, it extends the parsing time. So we will uncheck that for this example. Now, when you've added the PCAP files that you would like to parse, click Next. If you're using the trial version of the software, you will be prompted with the warning that you are using the trial version, the limited trial version. Click Yes to continue. Now, we can choose the types of files we want to parse. For this example, I will just choose the POP3 email and the HTTP content. Selecting More will extend the parsing time. Click Next when you're finished. Now you'll be prompted to confirm this action, click yes. Now the parsing process begins. Click finished. Now we can see in the object list that we've populated the types of objects. We'll start with the HTTP content. In the records list, we can see the different records of our data. And in the data content table, we can see more detailed information about our records. Now, let's look at a reconstructed file. We'll look at a Yahoo page. When you click on the record, the corresponding application will open the file. Because this is HTTP, we're looking at the HTTP reader. We can see Yahoo Taiwan page that was recorded. And all the reconstructed data. Let's close this, and let's look at another record. Here is Yahoo Canada News, so we can see the reconstructed news story. Now, let's look at the POP3 record. We have three records. When you click the POP3 record, the corresponding application will open the file. Here's Outlook. And we can see the email that was sent. Also the reconstructed attachments. Now, to close the case, go to File, and then select Close Case. These are the basic functions of this powerful but easy-to-use tool. Next, I will show you some of the advanced features of FIT. Now, let's go through enabling the search function. Let's start again, and we'll have a look. We have case example 3, case 1. Let's create a new case. So we'll have case 2. Name your case. Click OK to continue. Now let's add some PCAP files to this case. Click Next. Now we're going to leave the Run Full Text Searching Index After Import option checked. We're going to add some files. Let's add these three files. Click Open. You see those three files. Click Next. Again, if you're running the trial version of the software, you will see a prompt reminding you that this is a limited version. Click Yes to continue. Okay, we're going to uncheck all. We're going to just check the POP3 and the HTTP content options. Click Next to continue. You'll be asked for a confirmation to execute the action. Click Yes. Now the parsing begins. You will see the search indexing after the parsing process is complete. Okay. here the full text indexing. Click Finish. Now let's look at our HTTP content. We'll click Story here. We'll open a record. Now let's do a search. Let's look for right here. Let's look for Montreal. We'll close this. Now we can do a search for Montreal. Now this will look at all the text in every record and find the word Montreal. Montreal. And that is our search function. Now let's continue and we'll look at the SSL. Currently there's no SSL records. So what we'll do is we're going to open another case. So let's close this case. Okay, let's open a new case. That was case 4. Click OK to continue. Now let's add files. We will uncheck the search function. Add. Now we're going to pick some common HTTPS content along with our usual content. We will uncheck all. We'll add POP3 HTTP content. And this time what we're going to do is add SSL to this. And also let's add connections, and we'll look at this option as well. Click Next to continue. As we add more functions to parse, the parsing process will be extended. Okay, now our parsing process is complete. Click Finish and we'll come down here. Now we can see that we have SSL records. The SSL records are able to capture and decode the HTTPS files. However, we don't see the reconstructed file. We do get a record. So that's our record. Now I want to take you through the registration process if you want to use the full version instead of the free trial. Come over here, find the Forensics Investigation Toolkit folder, and then go to Generate Signature File. Click on that, and you'll be asked for a product serial number. If you don't already have a product serial number, please email to registry@decision.com.tw and cc to isabella@decision.com.tw asking for the serial number. You will be returned a sales form to order the full version. And when you return the sales form purchasing the product, then you will be returned a serial number. When you have the serial number, enter the serial number in here and then click OK. That will generate a signature file. When you have the signature file, return the signature file, attach the file to an email to the same addresses, registry and Isabella, and then you'll be returned a license file. Once you have the license file, you can come back over here to the Forensics Investigation Toolkit and click on the Register License File. Once you find the license file, click Open, and then you'll have a registered full version. This concludes our tutorial. Thank you for listening to this tutorial about the powerful and easy to use Forensics Investigation Toolkit by Decision Group. If you have any questions, please feel free to email decision@decision.com.tw. Thank you.